So today, we're going to build a snow cave.
How to build a Quinzee and other types of snow shelters.
So I'm doing this all with my buddy Greg, who's a survival expert up here in Boardman, Wisconsin. And a Quinzee is basically a type of snow cave.
This here is the beginning of one of our Quinzees, and I'm going to get into detail on exactly how we built it from step one all the way to finishing it up. But first, let me walk through some of the other types of snow caves that you can build so you can get a bigger picture to this whole snow shelter thing. Now, one of the main reasons you build a snow shelter is to protect yourself from the elements. With snow as your building tool, you have a few options, much of which depends on the tools you have at hand, and if you're in either a survival situation, camping, or if you're just out for fun. So let me go through a few of them. First, a simple snow cave, which you could easily build by basically burrowing into the side of a snowbank, a big snow drift. If you've ever dug into the bank where a snowplow is built up, that's basically what you're building. But I should say, keep in mind it's super dangerous to do that because, well, the snowplow could come back and then you'd be buried. So never build your snow cave there. Then there is a simple tree pit. Tree pits are when you use an existing tree and then you dig down to the ground. You pull over some branches to cover yourself up, insulate yourself from the elements. Next, a snow trench. Essentially, you can dig a small horizontal trench in the snow.
Trench?
Yep, snow trench.
Then cover it with blocks that you've cut out in kind of a tent-like fashion. We did this right here. Now we did need a small saw to cut out the blocks, but the benefit here is that as a survival shelter, it's much easier to build than a Quinzee because you're not using big shovels, you're not crawling into tight places, and overall spending a ton of energy.
With snow blocks for a roof?
Plus, you don't get nearly as wet. And in a survival situation, those are important things to think about. And then on the extreme end, you could build an igloo. We've probably all seen igloos. The Eskimos and Inuit have perfected this technique, coming up with tricks to make it awesome. But essentially, it's a dome built with blocks you've cut out of the snow. And it takes time, but as you can see from this little block we cut out of the snow that we just stomped down, it's not terribly difficult. It'll take some time though, and you can't build it much bigger than 10 feet across or you'll have to get a perfect dome. But more on igloo building in a future video. Finally, we made a Quinzee, which at its most basic level is making a snow cave into snow that you've piled up. So here are the steps we took to building our Quinzee. First, we picked an area that was flat with a lot of snow. Then we started shoveling it up into a single pile. What this does is change the physical nature of the snow. It's really light and fluffy when you start digging. Then by piling it up and stomping it down, it melts a little bit, recrystallizes. Essentially, it makes it really strong. In fact, you only have to wait a few hours for this process to happen and start digging it out. But before you start digging, a good practice is to actually stick a bunch of small twigs around the top of the dome, about 12 inches in, so that when you start digging out, you know how close you are to the surface.
Yeah, so even if your stick's longer, I would just grab it up to a foot and stick it up to where my hand is.
Okay. Some people just depend on looking for light coming through the top, and we didn't do that though because there wasn't a lot of light around when we were digging, and we didn't want to break through. And now for the tunneling part, which is definitely the hardest part.
We're gonna start an entrance right here.
Because there were four of us, we started on four sides and we started digging into the middle. There aren't a lot of tips to offer here, except to say it takes a lot of work. So make sure you're wearing some good waterproof clothing. You're gonna get pretty wet in the end. And that's because there's a lot of laying on your back and the snow coming down on you.
Okay.
But pretty soon, one tunnel hits the other.
I'm gonna hand you the GoPro. Oh gosh, we're a little ways though. Can you grab this?
Oh yeah. I can touch, I'm right through here. Hey. We're almost here. Oh, that's a tiny hole through.
Finally poked through, look at that.
At some point, we had one person inside throwing snow out to someone on the entrance. And I'd also suggest making it at least tall enough that you can sit up in it. That definitely helps for the claustrophobia.
I guess I'm kind of claustrophobic. When this wasn't carved out like it is right now, I was kind of freaking out.
Then we covered three of the holes, but not fully airtight. See, the key in a snow shelter is to make sure you have air, so you don't want to seal it all up. And it's nice to have a couple holes on either end, or you could lose a little bit of oxygen.
And that is how you build a Quinzee.
Now before I wrap this up, I want to show you some of the things I have in store for future videos, stuff we did for the course. Definitely lots of knife work.
Oh jeez.
Don't pull it out.
Fire building, especially in the snow.
No!
I'm
God!
And let me just say, winter fire building is definitely trickier because you have to find dry wood.
It's a mushroom that's really hard and flammable, kind of burn like coal.
And we always do a lot of natural history stuff. That means learning about the plants and the animals, because that's my background.
This is the type of fungus.
Making ropes and tying knots. Making a kitchen in the snow.
This is amazing, right? This.
So the reason we are doing these winter courses is I just feel like it's so important to get back to the basics sometimes. Start to learn what it's like to live and camp in the wild. I think it can be good to allow you to live healthier and happier. It's also really fun. Get to know the plants and the animals in certain places that we're at. But if you want to come on a future trip, StoneAgeMan.com, you can see what other trips are going on. And yeah, and we'll see you in future videos too.